Welcome back for another example of solving a system of three linear equations with three unknowns using the elimination method. It's important to keep in mind that when solving a system like this, there's actually three possibilities. We can have one solution, no solution, or an infinite number of solutions. One way to recognize this is that if we were to graph these in space, each of these would be a plane, and when we graph three planes in space, there are three outcomes. One is they intersect in a single point as we see here, which means there's one solution to the system, and therefore the system is consistent and independent. The other outcome, pictured here, is there are no points that are on all three planes, and therefore there's no solution, and the system is inconsistent. And the third possibility is that there's an infinite number of points on all three planes. Notice these three planes intersect in a line. We know a line contains an infinite number of points. Therefore, it's possible that a system has infinite solutions, meaning the system is consistent and dependent. So when solving a system like this, it is important to keep that in mind. Now, to keep things organized, let's go ahead and label our equations. This will be equation A, equation B, and equation C. Normally, when solving a system of three equations with three unknowns, we can select any two equations to eliminate either the x, y, or z terms. But in this case, notice that equation B only contains x and z, which means if we use equation A and equation C to eliminate the y terms, then we'll have two equations that contain just x and z, which we can use to solve this system. So if we want to add equations A and C to eliminate the y terms, we want the y terms to be opposites. So if we multiply equation A by -1, the y terms would be opposites. So for the first step, let's go ahead and multiply equation A by -1 and then add it to equation C. Well, -1 times equation A would be -2x minus y minus 11z equals -4. We're leaving equation C the same, so we have x plus y plus 8z equals 3. And now we'll add these two equations together. Notice how the y terms are opposites, so this sum would be 0. So we'll have -1x or -x, and then -3z equals -1. Let's go ahead and call this equation D. Now notice that equation B and equation D only contain x and z. So now we'll set up a system involving equations B and D to hopefully solve for x and z, and then come back and find y. So we want to solve the system x plus 3z equals 0, and -x minus 3z equals -1. And again, this was equation B, and this was equation D. Well, notice how the x terms and the y terms are already opposites, so we can go ahead and add these two equations together. But notice when we do this, both the x terms and the z terms are opposites. Therefore, the left side would just be 0, and on the right side we have 0 plus -1, which is equal to -1. So whenever all the variables simplify out and we're left with an equation like this, it's either going to be a true equation or a false equation. Well, we know that 0 does not equal -1, so when this equation is false, this is telling us that the system has no solution. Therefore, we can say we have an inconsistent system, which means if we graph these three planes in space, there will not be any points that are on all three planes. So let's go ahead and take a look at the graph of this. Here's the graph of the three planes. Notice how, because two of these planes are parallel, there aren't any points that are on all three planes, and therefore we have no solution. Okay, I hope you found this explanation helpful. Thank you for watching.